Okay. Would you support a bill to codify DACA and protect 800,000 young people from deportation?
No. I think.
Yeah, why?
Why? You are creating a situation in which many, many people are illegal, and you're just saying, we should all make them legal tomorrow. And I think there's some confusion on immigration across the board. Okay, there's some people who, in any individual case, say that we should let more people in the country. And we should pick good people to be immigrants in the country, not blanket across the board. You know, we do not need people who might commit crimes, we do not need people who might take advantage of our welfare systems. Historically in this country, our immigrants have been an overall plus. I think our goal should be every immigrant a good immigrant, not sweeping across the board amnesties. And a problem with that is, well, by the way, is when you do have a sweeping across the board amnesty, you wind up with a lot of people in gray areas going before courts, and you always wind up with more, I think, than was intended. But on DACA, it's not a horrible thing to say because your parents are here, because you've been here for 12 years, you don't get to be a citizen. I mean, I can think of a lot of Americans you run into from time to time. They were raised abroad, maybe their parents were missionaries, maybe they worked for the State Department, maybe they were in the military. And they were raised outside the United States, but they always knew they were American. It wasn't a traumatic thing to come back. I think part of the problem is, too, we have over 195 countries right now. I should look, Google it, and find out exactly how many countries we have. But it's not the end of the world if some people don't live in the United States. And I think some people, when you talk to them, they always think like it's a horrible thing if somebody can't live in the United States. A small percentage of the world lives here, and it's not the end of the, you know, like I said, it's not the end of the world that people have to go back to the country to be their citizens.
It's the end of the world if you're a teenager and you're a junior in high school, and it's all you've ever known, and suddenly you're sent back to Mexico. It's the end of the world.
Yeah, sure.
These are my classmates. I know these people. I'm friends with them.
It's definitely
very
the end
unfair.
Of the world.
Totally unfair.
So you would want them deported, is what you're saying.
Depends on the individual.
Well,
they're already, they've already passed the test. They're in school. They're in the military. They're in professions.
Uh-huh.
You want them deported?
Depends on the individual.
The Pope come out against
it.
He says the family is
criminal.
ICE
is going door to door. They're not doing individual things. That is a fact.
Well, they should be individual.
Yeah.
Okay. Your policy, your thoughts are wrong, I believe. I think if we had a show of hands, you'd find that your ideas aren't good.
Well, my husband's a legal immigrant, and he had to do a whole bunch of things to get here.
I have friends who are legal immigrants from Russia, though.
I have a daughter-in-law who's a legal immigrant, but she has been treated with prejudice because of her accent and her color. And even though she is legal, she knows more about the United States than I bet you do.
Well, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Sorry I wasn't here the last time we did this. We're talking about arranging another few and a couple.